Thank you for the opportunity to share my story with this committee and for bringing light to the crisis of abuse in amateur sports. Your commitment to ensuring the safety of gymnasts and all amateur athletes is appreciated, important, and necessary to ensure nothing like this ever happens again. Please bear with me. To be perfectly honest, I can imagine no place that I would be less comfortable right now than sitting here in front of you, sharing these comments. My name is Simone Biles, and I am a gymnast who has trained at the levels of the sport. As an elite gymnast, I have had the honor to represent the United States of America in multiple international competitions, including world championships and the Olympic Games. Over the course of my gymnastics career, I have won 25 world championship medals and 7 Olympic medals for Team USA. That record means so much to me, and I am proud of my representation of this nation through gymnastics. I am also a survivor of sexual abuse, and I believe without a doubt that the circumstances that led to my abuse and allowed it to continue are directly the result of the fact that the organizations created by Congress to oversee and protect me as an athlete, USA Gymnastics and the United States Olympic and Paralympic Committee failed to do their jobs. Nelson Mandela once said, there can be no keener revelation of a society's soul than the way in which it treats its children. It is the power of that statement that compels and empowers me to be here in front of you today. I don't want another young gymnast, Olympic athlete, or any individual to experience the horror that I and hundreds of others have endured before, during, and continuing to this day in the wake of the Larry Nassar abuse. To be clear,
take your time.
To be clear, I blame Larry Nassar, and I also blame an entire system that enabled and perpetrated his abuse. USA Gymnastics and the United States Olympic and Paralympic Committee knew that I was abused by their official team doctor long before I was ever made aware of their knowledge. In May of 2015, Rhonda Fahan, the former head of USA Gymnastics women's program, was told by my friend and teammate, Maggie Nichols, that she suspected I, too, was a victim. I didn't understand the magnitude of what all was happening until the Indianapolis Star published its article in the fall of 2016, entitled, "Former USA Gymnastics Doctor Accused of Abuse." Yet while I was a member of the 2016 US Olympic team, neither USAG, USOPC, nor the FBI ever contacted me or my parents. While others had been informed and investigations were ongoing, I had been left to wonder why I was not told until after the Rio Games. This is the largest case of sexual abuse in the history of American sport. And although there have been a fully independent investigation of the FBI's handling of the case, neither USAG nor USOPC have ever been made the subject of the same level of scrutiny. These are the entities entrusted with the protection of our sport and our athletes, and yet it feels like questions of responsibility and organizational failures remain unanswered. As you pursue the answers to those questions, I ask that your work be guided by the same question that Rachel Denhollander and many others have asked: how much is a little girl worth? I sit before you today to raise my voice so that no little girl must endure what I, the athletes at this table, and the countless others who needlessly suffered under Nassar's guise of medical treatment, which we continue to endure today. We suffered and continue to suffer because no one at FBI, USAG, or the USOPC did what was necessary to protect us. We have been failed, and we deserve answers. Nassar is where he belongs, but those who enabled him deserve to be held accountable. If they are not, I am convinced that this will continue to happen to others across Olympic sports. In reviewing the OIG's report, it truly feels like the FBI turned a blind eye to us and went out of its way to help protect USAG and USOPC. A message needs to be sent. If you allow a predator to harm children, the consequences will be swift and severe. Enough is enough. I will close with one final thought. The scars of this horrific abuse continue to live with all of us. As the lone competitor in the recent Tokyo Games who was a survivor of this horror, I can assure you that the impacts of this man's abuse are not ever over or forgotten. The announcement in the spring of 2020 that the Tokyo Games were to be postponed for a year meant that I would be going to the gym, to training, to therapy, living daily among the reminders of this story for another 365 days. As I have stated in the past, one thing that helped me push each and every day was the goal of not allowing this crisis to be ignored. I worked incredibly hard to make sure that my presence could maintain a connection between the failures and the competition at Tokyo 2020. That has proven to be an exceptionally difficult burden for me to carry, particularly when required to travel to Tokyo without the support of any of my family. I am a strong individual and I will persevere, but I never should have been left alone to suffer the abuse of Larry Nassar. And the only reason I did was because of the failures that lie at the heart of the abuse that you are now asked to investigate. Again, I appreciate the opportunity to share my thoughts with this committee today. I want to sincerely thank each of you for joining the survivors of this abuse to do what we all can to prevent anything like this from ever happening again.
They were brutally, brutally honest, emotionally vulnerable, as they so aptly described what had happened to them. And it's not only the facts that they brought out, because the facts are horrendous. The fact that the FBI in Indianapolis field office, and as it was said by senators coast to coast, knew what was happening but covered it up for more than 1 year. But Simone Biles said that back at the Caroli Ranch, which was the national training facility in Texas, back in 2015, Once it became known that it looked like Larry Nassar was abusing some of the young gymnasts, that it was going around that she was one that was being abused. They didn't tell her. They didn't ask her. Not until after 2016 in Rio did she say someone confronted her. Ali Reisman testified that it was 14 months after she spoke with someone at the FBI that they ever came to her. They ever questioned her further on all of this. But it was Michaela Maroney, who was gymnast number one in the Inspector General's report, who with so much specificity talked about how she was violently sexually assaulted by Larry Nassar before and after the London Olympics, shortly after she had gotten her medal. And it went on from there internationally. John?
And Jean, as you speak, I just want to tell our viewers what they're seeing. We're still live pictures in the committee hearing room. Senators now talking to these American athletes who are just as well. Also, they are gold medalists. They are international icons. They are survivors of horrific sexual abuse. And Paula Reed, as you join the conversation, we may hear from these young women momentarily. We're told they may speak to reporters when they leave the hearing room. We'll take you up there live if they do. What was stunning is that, you know, yes, Larry Nassar is in prison for 150 years. Plus, he will spend the rest of his life in prison. But these women and others sitting behind them who did not testify believe justice is not even close to being served in this case. They have questions about the Olympic Committee, questions about the FBI. And what was stunning to me is to listen to Ali Reisman say, even after, as Jean just noted, she made her allegations, even after she knew the investigation was underway, that there were other young women, including some sitting in that courtroom, I mean, in that hearing room, excuse me, who went to Dr. Nassar because they thought it was cool to have the same doctor as the Olympic athletes, and those girls were not warned, even though the investigation was well underway.
Look, there's very few points of bipartisan agreement in this town right now, but one thing you see both sides of the aisle agree on completely is that the handling of this matter, of this investigation, was a national tragedy. And when you're looking at abuse on this scale, pedophiles, people who sexually abuse children on this scale, whether it's Jerry Sandusky, Jeffrey Epstein, here Larry Nassar, it takes a village to enable that, to cover something like this up. So this really wasn't about Larry Nassar. It was about the system that protected him, that enabled him to continue this abuse, even as claims were being brought. And Simone Biles, you know, she really did make the point, as did some of the other women, that this isn't about him. This is about the system. And they were very specific. They said point blank, they want to see criminal prosecutions. We know the Office of Inspector General made some criminal referrals, but at this point, those referrals are not being acted on. We do not anticipate at this point any criminal prosecutions of those FBI officials who were named in the Inspector General report. And of course, the FBI director and the Inspector General himself will be testifying about this shortly.
And you just saw the four gymnasts leaving the hearing room and walking down the hall. It does not appear that they're going to speak to reporters as they leave the hearing room. We'll continue to monitor that if they will. This hearing will continue. The committee has questions for the Justice Department Inspector General, who looked into FBI conduct and the like. Again, we're showing you live pictures here up on Capitol Hill. These heroic gymnasts, survivors of sexual assault, folks with them up there. Gene, some of the senators were asking, what else do you want from us? Among the answers were federal prosecution, not just state prosecution, and even these gymnasts saying that, yes, some safeguards have been put in place, but questioning whether they are working effectively.
John, it's very interesting because Simone very quietly said, we want a federal prosecution. Here's what happened. The Inspector General's report actually made criminal referrals to the Attorney General's office, and it was confirmed today in the introductory statements that they refused prosecution. And so because of that, could there be a limit on some that can be prosecuted? Because the Inspector General was able to get some interviews from FBI officials because the Attorney General said they would not be prosecuting this case. However, Jay Abbott, who was the special agent in charge of the FBI office in Indianapolis, he voluntarily did speak to the Inspector General. He still can be federally prosecuted, along with if more information would come out, if there would be a special prosecutor and a criminal investigation, more information of a criminal nature that could extend potential criminal charges in this matter.